racks and shelves contain a lot of books. Tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, perhaps millions. How do you feel about them? Do they mean something to you? Are they your friends? Have you a real love of books and learning?
So have you read a good book lately? How about Slaughterhouse-Five or Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone? You might be surprised. These are just two books that have been banned or challenged and deemed inappropriate or even dangerous to society.
Book banning, indeed book burning, is central to the story of After Twilight. Our heroine is Jen Frazier, a young librarian who is faced with the onerous task of pulling books from the shelves to be burned by the Texas theocratic government. In the 2004 short film production of After Twilight, actor Don Hampton played the role of Sergeant Streetman, the head of the religious police.
I live in a county just north of here that recently had an outbreak of book banning by an extreme religious right organization. And my girlfriend of some years is the head of the children's library group, and as such is on the review board. These people raised such a stir that they got a county judge to actually ban a couple of books. So it was a very interesting parallel for me.
Every year since 1982, for a week in late September, libraries, schools, and bookstores draw attention to books that have been banned or challenged, highlighting the dangers of censorship. Naturally, it's called Banned Book Week.
The list of banned and challenged books is long. Here are just some of the titles on that list, and some may be surprising.
Is a human right, and a healthy society values all sorts of opinions, even ones we may not agree with. The French philosopher Voltaire said it best, "I do not agree with what you have to say, but I'll defend to the death your right to say it."